Welcome back. Today we're going to continue the glucose metabolism and we're going to focus on the pentose phosphate pathway. Okay, so we start as always with glucose. Glucose gets inside the cell, then the exokinase acts on glucose to create glucose 6-phosphate. Exo means 6, kinase means phosphate, so 6-phosphate. Then glucose 6-phosphate is converted into 6-phosphogluconolactone via the glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase. And every time you hear dehydrogenase means NAD positive to NADH. Then the 6-phosphogluconolactone gets converted into 6-phosphogluconate via the lactonase enzyme. 6-phosphogluconate is then converted into ribulose 5-phosphate via the 6-phosphogluconate dehydrogenase, another NAD positive to NADH, and this step is not reversible. This is called the oxidative phase of the pentose phosphate pathway. Ribulose 5-phosphate is then converted into ribose 5-phosphate via an isomerase, since these are very similar molecules. Or it can be converted into xylose 5-phosphate via an epimerase. These are diastereoisomers. Then ribose 5-phosphate with xylose 5-phosphate, they're going to get combined together with a transketolase. A transketolase is getting two carbons from one molecule and giving it to the other. How many carbons? Two in this case. Remember, keto, the keto group, is on carbon number two. So that's a little mnemonic to remember it. Transketolase. And the results are glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and ceduloheptose 7-phosphate. How many carbons here? 7. Here, 3. Okay. Then these two are going to get combined together via a transaldolase. This time we transfer 3 carbons. And as you can see, from here to here. And we get fructose 6-phosphate and erythrose 4-phosphate. And now something pretty cool happens. As you can see here, xylose 5-phosphate can be bind to erythrose 4-phosphate via a transketolase again. And this will create glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and fructose 6-phosphate. But wait a second. We know these guys. They are metabolites of glycolysis. We already discussed them. And as you can see, if you follow the arrows, they are into glycolysis steps. So what does this mean? Well, it means that when you have glucose 6-phosphate, you can either continue the glycolysis, the normal glycolysis pathway, or you can enter the pentose phosphate pathway and then return into glycolysis or gluconeogenesis, whatever it is, because these steps are all combined together. That's why I draw the arrows between them. Because these metabolites can continue glycolysis or gluconeogenesis. By the way, these steps are the non-oxidative phase in which you can create ribose 5-phosphate, which is the main focus here, because ribose 5-phosphate is the metabolite for creating nucleotides. You can create it without creating NADH,
This is the oxidative phase, and this is a non-oxidative phase. In this one, we create NADHs, and in this one, we do not create NADHs. Because all these steps are reversible, as you can see. So I can enter glycolysis, and maybe get here to fructose 6-phosphate, and combining it with erythrose 4-phosphate, and get those two. And then those two can be put together to form ribose 5-phosphate and xylose 5-phosphate. You get the point? This is all interchangeable. I hope you understood it well, and I think it's a very good thing if you leave me a like or comment down below to give me a feedback.